everyone. Welcome to our Facebook Live event. My name is Sue Barros, and I'm the Director of Admissions for Tulane University School of Public Health and Tropical Medicine. Today's interview is going to be with Clinical Associate Professor Jean Zhao from our Global Biostatistics and Data Sciences Department. Jean, would you like to introduce yourself and tell us how you came to work here at Tulane?
Hi everyone, I'm Jean, and I'm from Department of Biostatistics, and actually, so you promoted me, I'm a clinical assistant professor at the department. I wish someday I will.
You will.
Thanks.
Okay, so how did you get to come to work at Tulane?
Well, 6 years ago, I know there's projects going on in the center of bioinformatics and the genomics, and I know the director of this center, that's Dr. Hong Wenden, and he was a chairman at the time, right? Yeah.
So you knew him, and that's how you got to, you were interested in the study, right?
Yeah, that's why I'm here.
Okay, and your study, the study we're talking about today is the Louisiana Osteoporosis Study. And can you tell us a little bit about that study and explain what osteoporosis is?
Oh, okay, yes. I'm the principal investigator of this study, Louisiana Osteoporosis Study. This is the biggest osteoporosis study in the south of the United States. Nice. And the goal of the study is to recruit about 20,000 subjects to understand the risk factors for osteoporosis. So far, we have recruited about 14,000 subjects.
14,000 subjects. And what's the goal? 27?
20,000.
20,000.
Okay. We still have 6,000 to go.
Excellent. Okay, so in the study, I understand that whoever participates will be submitting specimens, right?
Yes. For each subject, we ask them to get to provide the consent for this study. Excellent. And fill a questionnaire and provide us the samples. Usually it's blood samples, it's 20 ml blood samples or 2 ml saliva samples.
So blood and saliva?
Yeah, from the saliva or blood, we extract the DNA to study the genetic factors for osteoporosis.
So there's genetic factors, but then there's also maybe environmental factors or self-inflicted factors, right?
Yes. There's some exercise, lack of exercise, or some diets, or some diseases can cause osteoporosis.
Okay, so that's what would be identified with the specimens, right?
Yes. From the specimen, mm-hmm. like blood and saliva, we extract the DNA and we genotype them, mm-hmm. like the whole genome sequences that currently we are doing. And from do the analysis based on the DNA sample, and there's genetic information from the DNA sample, and the phenotype data, like the obesity phenotype or bone mm-hmm. phenotype, we will understand that which genetic factors contribute to osteoporosis or obesity.
That's impressive. There's a scan component too. So can you tell us about the scan? And I think you have some information to share with us, right?
Oh yeah, talking about the bone scan. That's the favorite part I want to talk about. Actually, I bring my laptop with me.
Great, let's look
at it.
Let's look at the bone scan.
Okay, this is our website for Louisiana Osteoporosis Study.
Okay.
And for this part is back part. Okay, so for this part, this is talking about the bone scan and the bone scan results. Okay, by the way, this is compared with a healthy bone and the osteoporosis bone.
And this is your femur?
This is a healthy bone, and there's osteoporosis bone. You see,
great.
There's a lot of holes.
I see.
And this is the bone scan results. For the bone scans,
we can bring it back up.
Okay, I need to go to this website, sorry.
That's okay.
Okay, so for this bone scan, the participant will lie a padded platform, and then the machine, the arm will pass the whole body, and then we will get the results. This is a bone scan results. This is for this whole body, and it's a spine and female neck. It's a part that usually for the person have osteoporosis, so they easily to get break.
So the scan scans three areas of your body, your spine and your femur.
Your spine, your femur, and your whole body.
The whole body.
Yeah,
okay.
And also we do the forearm.
Okay, and the forearm.
Yes.
Excellent.
And this results can tell you whether you have osteoporosis or not based on the T-score.
So it's a T-score. And can you tell us the different ranges for T-scores in the bone
okay,
scan?
Okay, yes. The T-score is a standard deviation that for your bone mass
okay.
compared to the young people with mm-hmm. your race your mm-hmm. and your gender. So if the T-score is bigger than -1, then you have normal bone. If your T-score is between -1 and -2.5, then you have osteopenia,
mm-hmm.
and you have a high chance to get osteoporosis. If your T-score is below -2.5, then you have osteoporosis.
And you have osteoporosis.
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is the results for this person.
And there's the T-score.
This is T-score, yeah. That's, and this score is a standard deviation for your bone mass compared to a person with your age. It's the same gender
okay.
and the same age
mm-hmm.
and the same race. Oh, this is, I want to introduce this scan to you. This is my favorite part, and we call this a blue man.
The blue man?
Yeah, by the way, this is me. This is me. And from the blue man, you can see that's blue color. That's blue color is the bone.
It's the bone.
And the fat is in
yellow
color,
mm-hmm.
and the red is the muscle.
Mm-hmm.
And for this results, this is a Z-score for your total body fat, and tells you what's your percentage of fat mass has. And this is, this results is, maybe you know that is body mass index.
Yes,
yeah,
BMI.
BMI index to
right.
classify whether a person is underweight, normal, or overweight, or obese.
Okay.
And you can see I'm normal.
Excellent. I'm glad to hear that.
And okay, my favorite part. Okay, this is a body composition result, and it shows that each side of your body,
mm-hmm.
how much fat you have,
right.
and how much lean mass, that's muscle you have.
Okay.
So here you can see I have more percentage fat mass in my left arm,
uh-huh.
right arm.
Close to your right arm.
Left, right.
Are you right-handed? Is that why?
Let's see, right arm I have 41 and left arm I have 42%.
Okay.
I have less fat in my right arm.
Good.
And I have less fat in my legs, left leg and right leg. That's about 35% and 33%. So, and my total percentage fat mass is about 32%, and I always want to lose weight. So from this result, I can see, okay, if I want to be a fitness woman, I want to have my percentage fat mass is about 25%.
Mm-hmm.
I can calculate that how much weight I need to lose.
Excellent. Thank you for sharing your personal scan results with us. I love seeing that. And Facebook friends, we are going to post these on the website so you'll be able to see them closely and compare them when Dr. Jean's speaking. So I understand that there might be some compensation for anyone that participates in this.
Oh yes. For Louisiana Osteoporosis Study, we provide free parking and
we provide
$25 Walmart gift card.
Okay, so there's a gift card and then parking is free as well. And who is available to participate in this study?
For this study is only for adults. So for people who are older than 18 years old.
Uh-huh.
And we recruit both male and female, and there's no race limitation for this both Asian or Caucasian or whatever, African Americans.
So welcome to all genetics.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. And then let's see, this is not the only research project you're involved in, right? There's others?
Yeah, we have several projects going on. And the biggest one is male osteoporosis study. And this study we just get funded from NIH. And the goal of this study is to study male osteoporosis to understand why some males have fragile bone and somebody have a healthy bone, and which factors contribute to bone mineral density variation. So in that study, we will recruit 1,100 subjects. That's for only for male with age between 20 to 50, and only recruit Caucasian males and African American males.
Okay.
And in that study, we provide a stipend $150 because that's more samples that we need to collect.
Well, that congratulations on receiving funding from the NIH, National Institute of Health, right?
Thank you.
And
yes,
that sounds like an interesting study. So many of you probably are fulfill these requirements and can participate in this study. So we will post the information of how you can do that, but I'll give it to you right now. You would go to los.sph.tulane.edu, and that stands for Louisiana Osteoporosis Study.
You have a good memory.
Public Health. Thank you. And then the telephone number is 504-988-1016, and we'll post that as well, right? Okay.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Dr. Dean. I love having you here for our interview, and I hope we'll do this again.
Sure, yeah. Thanks.
Okay.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.